Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to learn about Birch reduction. Disubstituted alkynes undergo reduction with sodium in liquid ammonia to give transalkene as the major product. So mostly it gives transalkene. We know what is an alkyne. Alkyne is basically there will be a triple bond between two carbons. So if you see, this is ethyne. There is a triple bond between two carbon atoms, and also the valency of carbon is 4. Carbon can have 4 groups. Here what happens, this for this carbon, if you see, there are 3 bonds with another carbon, and for the fourth bond it has a hydrogen. This is ethyne. So ethyne, if you generally see, it has 2 hydrogen. Ethyne has 2 hydrogen. Now if these 2 hydrogen are substituted by some other group, it is known as a disubstituted alkyne. This is ethyne. This ethyne has 2 hydrogens, right? This hydrogen, if instead of hydrogen some other group is present, then we call it as a disubstituted. If you see here, I'll put methyl group. Similarly, here also I'll put methyl group. This is a disubstituted. Di or bi, it means 2. And for both the carbon, the hydrogen are substituted by some other group. And reduction can be defined in 3 ways. It is either addition of hydrogen, removal of oxygen, or addition of electrons. Addition of hydrogen, removal of oxygen, addition of electrons. If any of these things are happening, it is reduction. Okay, and if you see, major product is a transalkene. This transalkene, what is this and what is trans? If you see, this is an alkene, right? In this alkene, if you see, between two carbons there is a double bond, and if you see, this carbon has one methyl group and one hydrogen. Similarly, this carbon has one methyl group and one hydrogen. Now if you see, both the methyl groups lie on the same side. If you see, if you just draw a line and if you check, both the methyl groups lie on the same side. Similarly, both the hydrogen lie on the same side. This is told to be cis form. Okay, cis or sister, together on the same side. Remember like this. Okay, remember like this. And if you see this one, this is wrong. This is correct, but this is wrong. Why? Because you have to consider cis, consider the compound cis only when different groups are attached to one carbon. If you see, for this carbon, both the groups are methyl groups. It cannot be like that. Then this is not cis. Similarly, for this carbon, both are hydrogen. Same groups are present. So this is wrong. Okay. But here if you see, for this carbon you have one methyl group and one hydrogen, two different groups are present. So you can consider this as cis. Now if you, in trans, if you see, similar groups are present on the opposite sides. Okay, you draw a line like this, you can see similar groups are present on the opposite sides. It will form a cross like thing, so it is transform. So I hope you understood what is disubstituted alkyne, what is reduction, and what are cis and transforms. Now if you see the reaction, disubstituted alkynes undergo reduction with sodium in liquid ammonia to give transalkene as the major product. Predominantly transalkene will be formed. So Birch reduction, if you see, this is the reaction, this is an alkyne, and this is disubstituted alkyne. Why it is a disubstituted alkyne? Because both the hydrogen have been substituted by methyl group. When you are going to add sodium in liquid ammonia, what is going to be formed? Transalkene. Trans, this is trans because in this alkene, if you see, opposite sides, similar groups are present in the opposite sides, so it is a transalkene. Okay, now let's name this. If you see, this has 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon, so it is butyne. And this, if you see, this is transbutene. This is transbutene. It has 4 carbons, but then it is an alkene and trans. position. So it is a transform, which means two similar groups are present in the opposite sides. Okay, and also one more thing, if you see, how can we say reduction is happening here? If you see, what is happening? Electrons are being accepted by the carbon. If you just see, there are three bonds over here, but in the product there are only two bonds, which means one bond has two electrons, right? These two electrons just go to either carbon. So what happens is the bond is broken. So in this way we say that reduction is also happening. Okay, so if you really understood, if you like the video, do hit the thumbs up, share the video with your friends, and subscribe to my channel for more useful videos like this. Thank you so much.